back to Houston Life. Are you tired of the same old dating scene? Yep. You can spice things up by socializing with other singles in a fun setting that's full of adventure.
That's right. Mark Owen and Reed Johnson with Events and Adventures are joining us to talk all about it, along with our special guests, Melissa, Joe, Cherie, Lance, and Tanya. Welcome, everyone. So, Mark, I want to start with you. Events and Adventures, the whole idea is you get singles together, take them on adventures. You started this in Seattle back in 1987, right after a divorce.
Yeah, a long time ago, going through a divorce. Didn't want to get serious, but wanted to go out and have a good time. And I went looking for a club like this and realized that there wasn't anything. And so I started it.
Yeah, people oftentimes feel like going to a bar is the only way to meet someone. But Reed,
that's old school.
That's old school. Reed, tell us about some of the adventures that people can go on with.
We have adventures every single day of the week. So whether your schedule is like Tanya's or you're a nurse or a doctor and you only have Tuesday or Wednesday nights off, we provide an event or an adventure every single night of the week for people to do, whether it's having parties at our clubhouse or playing volleyball, going to the beach. We do something every single day.
So, Melissa, I got to ask you, what's your favorite adventure that you've done so far?
Oh, well, I'm not really big into sports until recently, and I've been able to go to a couple of the basketball games, and we actually get to go on the court and meet the players as they were coming on. That was amazing to me.
Well, that's kind of cool.
Wait a minute. Okay, so we should also explain, though, that if you're in a relationship, everybody is eligible, 21 plus, unless you are married. So you have to be single, right?
Yeah, have to be single.
Big draw. That right there is a big draw.
Yeah, what if people are just secretly pretending to be single, but they're married? Hopefully, do you ever have that issue?
We hopefully catch that in our filtering process.
Sorry, I just took the conversation to a dark.
Yeah. There is some screening that goes on in this process.
Yeah, sadly, in the world, there's people that do that all the time, that pretend they're married pretend they're single when they're really married.
You guys try to weed that out. Now, Cherie, you used to be a member of Events and Adventures.
Yes.
Something happened.
I met my husband. We were actually at a volleyball event, and we were playing volleyball, and he spiked the volleyball right into my face.
It's so romantic.
I know. It was the most romantic thing ever, and it just got better from there. I knew him for about 6 months before we even started dating, and then we got married in 2017. So I was a member from 2011 until 2013. Okay.
Very cool. Wow. And Joe, you're a single dad back in school. Why did you decide to join Events and Adventures?
You know, I found my days were filled with kids and work and then coming home, and I didn't really have a great way of meeting people. And I wanted to meet just friends to hang out with. And so I joined it for that. And there's a lot of great things. I like to do a lot of outdoors things like camping and going to the zoo for the zoo lights. And we did scavenger hunts. So I got to do all the things I love and meet people who do those same things. Made a lot of great guy friends, met a lot of great women, and just a lot of friendships really started.
So, Lance, why do Events and Adventures instead of online dating?
good question. I like it because you get to socially interact with people up front, and you don't have to go through that awkward moment, you know, talking to them online and trying to get to know them, and then trying to get that meetup, and you know you don't know really what you're getting, you know. Yeah. So it's good to know, and plus you can make, you know, friends with this person, and then, you know, form a relationship from there. You don't have to just like be in that nervous first stage. You're just like, hey. You know, we just met. We're already.
So you still like that one-on-one in-person interaction?
Yes.
Tanya, did you ever have an online dating experience or something that went wrong in your dating world that prompted you to join?
I mean, I have done the online dating. It hasn't worked out very well. But not necessarily that was the reason why I joined Events Adventures. I joined because I was new to the city and I didn't know anybody. And my life was going home, work, and I got tired of it, and I decided to join and meet up with people, and now I've made a lot of friendships, and I love hanging out with them.
This model has obviously worked because you guys have been around for 30 years. You also volunteer, but Reed, you just took a group. Why didn't y'all call me and let me know about this to Cuba?
Because we sold it out within the first couple of days of posting it, because our trips are open to all our members from all our cities. So Phoenix, Houston, Dallas, everybody all comes together. So it's an extra special adventure because we're not just going with the people that we know from Houston. We're making friends from our Vancouver club and all that kind of thing. So it was an amazing experience. I mean, it's 40-minute flight from Miami to Havana. and then but it's worlds away, and we had a spectacular time.
Now, guys, some people at home might be asking, how does this work? You have to join, pay a membership fee. Explain the details.
Yeah, it is a private club, so you have to, we interview everybody before they join.
An in-person interview.
In-person interview, because I found weirdos have a hard time holding it in for an hour. So we interview them, and, you know, most people are great, and every once in a while there's people you just don't want to meet. We try to keep those people from getting into the club, so I think that makes a big difference, because then when you're actually a member, you can relax, because you know that's been done. You don't have to worry about, you know, is this guy really single? You don't have to worry about those kind of things.
And Reed, really quickly, what are some of the other events and adventures that you guys have going on?
We've got our Memorial Day River trip coming up. That's always big. So we partner with our Dallas Club a lot for camping trips. We usually do an overnight trip every single month. So we'll go camping, or we'll go caving or rock climbing. And we do overnight trips once a month, like I said, with them, usually 50 to 100 people.
And then sometimes it's just a dinner somewhere too, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
And is it true there are events literally every night of the week and weekend?
Yes.
Yep. Oh, wow. All right. Well, thank you all for coming in and joining us. Now, for more information, you can visit eventsandadventures.com/Houston.
And there is much more Houston Life coming up next.